Paxton Brooks to kick as Tennessee won the toss and deferred. High short kick. Dejon Edwards. Oh, man, he took a shot at the 20, but he bounced out to around the 23-yard line. So it'll start with Stetson Bennett, the fourth. From walk-on to national champion. You all know the story. And now 22-3 as a starter, the pride and joy of Blackshear, Georgia. We spent a long time with him yesterday. Interesting young man. And so confident in he and his teammates. Kenny McIntosh will be with him in the backfield to start things on first down. And it is McIntosh in a gigantic hole off the right side, and he pops out for 9 before they can bring him down.
Only 2 teams in college football blitz as much as Tennessee. You're going to see right here, they start the game with a 5-man blitz. Georgia catches them.
And with tempo, the quick throw out, complete, but not for a first down to Kiaris Jackson. As we check the Papa John's lineups, joining Stetson Bennett and the rest of the offense, looks like this. Kenny McIntosh, great receiver out of the backfield. You saw what he can do as their tailback with that opening run, but now they face a third down on their opening drive. 3rd and 1. And they have been very good this year, as you see, 52% on the season. McConkey and Dylan Bell, the 2 wide receivers to the bottom. Bowers is the other way. McIntosh runs behind Bowers. First down and end zone.
Well, you can see Todd Monken, offensive coordinator for this Georgia offense, the respect he has. Goes outside, a bit of an influence play on 3rd and 1.
And again, Georgia going hurry up. Down the... Oh!
Man!
Almost intercepted by Jeremy Banks.
Tried to go play action pass, and how do you throw a low ball to the tallest guy in the field, Darnell Washington? Pulled the string just a bit, and that one could have been really bad.
That shocked Banks, I think.
Absolutely.
A little bit. His timing of his jump was perfect. His hands weren't. So 2nd down and 10. Bennett over the middle again, this time in some traffic to Bowers. First down.
Well, that's the matchup, right? All over the field. They call him a tight end, but he's an H-back tight end. He'll be tight sometimes, but he'll also get the matchup he wants against a strong safety. He's 4-5, 4-4-5 speed, and he's a nightmare for these defenses.
Dejon Edwards checks into the Georgia backfield now as they've moved it into Tennessee territory.
And now he's attached.
From the 47. Tennessee thinking about a blitz. Edwards trying to bounce it offside, and the ball is out. Tennessee almost had it, and Bennett.
I think,
wait a minute, he still might. Tennessee's got it. Bennett got on top of it, and then it scooted out of there, and Tamarian McDonald has got it.
It looked like Stetson Bennett was going to come from a good run and make it, but a play to the outside just put his hand on the football. And then the turnover. I think it was Bumpus that got the forced fumble. And then the fight was won by the Volunteers.
So great opportunity, as everybody says the turnover battle is going to be the difference. And Volunteers have been great this year. They're +9 right now. That's tops in the SEC, and Georgia is not. They're -1, and that -1 could cost them dearly here in the first quarter.
Well, if you're a follower of college football, you know what this Tennessee offense looks like. Wide splits, stacked receivers, and that's how they lined up.
High snap, Hooker over the middle, wide open is Jalen Hyatt on the run. Georgia trying to bring him down, and they do, but not before he got to the 40-yard line.
The variety of this offense looks like it's greater than it is, because a lot of the routes are choice routes.
Hooker, quick throw out in the flat to Tillman. Cedric Tillman, and a flag flies in. And Papa John's lineup starts with Hendon Hooker, who has already thrown two completions.
Pass was first touched behind the line of scrimmage. There is no foul for offensive pass interference. Result of the play is a first down.
So Tillman gets the first down.
Ness, I've had pizza delivered, and then I told him to wait till the next play. Just like this.
Just like this. Tillman back in last week, played 48 snaps. He was their big-time receiver at the beginning of the year. Jalen Hyatt has become that due to Tillman's injury. And flags fly before the snap.
I think it was the tight end fan or inside Carvin.
False start. Offense. Number 53.
So they're calling it on the center, but might have been Carvin, might have been set right in that inside of that offensive line.
Robert Beal with Nolan Smith out has got to bring the pressure off the edge for Georgia. Had a sack in this game a year ago. And now the crowd really into it because they got that 5 yards. At least they're going to take credit for it. First and 15.
And remember that Alabama game against Tennessee when Tennessee had the home field advantage. 17 penalties by Alabama. That crowd was a factor then. Will it be today?
Just outside the 40, first down at 15. Hooker, the play fake, throws to the outside, completes to Tillman again. Georgia runs him out of bounds. But he gets the penalty yardage and a little bit more back.
Well, Cedric Tillman went for over 200 yards in this game a year ago. And he's finally, I think he's kind of been on a pitch count. They finally got him ready for this game. That's what they've been pointing for, Tennessee.
Second and 9, Georgia comes with a blitz. Hooker stands in tall, delivers it to Hyatt. And they wrestle him down after a short gain. It'll be third down.
That is exactly what Kirby Smart was telling Jenny on the sideline. They're going to catch, but we've got to come up and make the tackle one-on-one. If we don't, it's going to be a long game.
Tennessee's a 50% third down team as well. Hooker down the middle, broken up. Georgia breaks it up at a flag. Smile Munden is the guy that was defending, but let's wait and see about the penalty.
I didn't know.
Prior to the snap, there was no play. False start, offense.
So that's two of them already.
5 yards penalty. Remains third down.
And that gets in your head after a while as an offense. You start listening to stuff that you shouldn't. It bothers you that you're making mistakes. The crowd, as Kirby begged for, has been a factor.
So third down at 10. And here comes that crowd again. And the Georgia defense asking for more noise. Hooker down the middle. It's complete, but well short of the first down. Might be in field goal range, though, on the pass to Fant over the middle.
Ness, when you consider that this Tennessee offense for the season has scored touchdown on half of their possessions. When they get the ball, they've scored a touchdown every other time they get the ball. Holding for a field goal try is what you're trying to accomplish against these wide open offenses.
Jace McGrath, who we saw hit the game winner against Alabama, will line it up from 47 yards out. Kick on the way. Dead center. Good opener for Tennessee. They had it moving. Georgia stiffened defensively and forced the field goal. Tennessee takes the lead early. Well, the standings have Tennessee number 1 and Ugga and the Dogs number 3. This week, get Not Stop Sports news, expert picks, and the biggest highlights on CBS Sports HQ, the free 24/7 sports news network. Download the CBS Sports app today. You can catch Gary with the HQ gang after this one's over. About the least amount of damage you could have done after that fumble, a 47-yard field
goal. Yeah, it's really, I feel, the key to the game. You know, both these offenses are going to move the ball, but which defense can get those stops? And sometimes a stop, field goal.
Yeah.
You got to be realistic here.
So Brooks will tee it up. Hendon Hooker was 5 for 5 on that opening Tennessee drive. Another pooch kick. This one's going to take a bounce at the 17. And Jackson, Kiaris Jackson, will pick it up and step out of bounds right across the 20. And I think right now Kirby Smart's saying if that ball would have gone out of bounds, we would have got it at the 35, Kiaris. But I'm not sure Kiaris wanted to wait for that to happen.
If it would have bounced the other way, you'd be yelling at
That's
me,
Coach. But Georgia's have some turnover issues the last few games. Stetson Bennett had a couple of misfires last week in Florida, interceptions. He only had one going into that Florida game. So 5 minutes in, Georgia trailing by three and starting at the 20. Both tight ends and McConkey in tight on the left side as Bennett drops to throw. Going to air it out. Man out there, and it's caught. Arian Smith. Big play for the Dogs. The speedster, number 11.
And that is the longest reception for any wide receiver, not tight end, for the Bulldogs all season. Their previous 37 yards by Ladd McConkey. They hadn't had a 40-yard pass all year for a wide receiver, and there you go, Coach. You said we could go deep. There's a lot of man-to-man played by this Tennessee defense. We talked about that. They blitz. They attack the quarterback. They play a lot of man-free defense.
Arian Smith is the fastest guy on the Georgia team. Just showed it there, and the pass was perfect. First down at the 28. Back to the ground, McIntosh. Little move in the hole, and he's still moving. Danny McIntosh all the way to the 13.
Now, Devin Willick, number 77, is in for Truss. Watch him start out this play at left guard. Watch his key block. Just takes Thomas clear out of the play, and that's exactly where they attack behind.
Great move in the hole by McIntosh after that excellent blocking, and Georgia's got it first and 10.
Key word, hole.
With one there.
There's that blitz look again. Banks goes wide, and they attack with five.
Bennett, the fade to the corner, trying to get it to Bowers. Little hand fighting going on over there. No flags, incomplete. And Stetson Bennett saying, that one's on me. Brandon Turnage was in coverage.
Yeah, anytime you get one-on-one coverage near the goal line with these tight ends, they're going to see the ball thrown their way. They like that matchup, those tight ends against safety-type players, not used to that bump-and-run coverage. Turnage plays a little corner, a little slot safety, but that's a different animal out there playing that tight end slot.
If you're just joining us, Georgia, this is their second possession, fumbled on their first. Now they've got it in the red zone at the 13, second down and 10. Bennett scans the field, throws to the end zone, incomplete, intended for Darnell Washington, and he just couldn't quite hold on. Throw was on target, a little bit low, but that's where it had to be.
Tennessee offensive line gave him plenty of time. It was delivered properly, good coverage on the play. Everybody did a little thing right there, except for the final part of it, catch the ball.
46 of 47. That's the highest in the nation. Tennessee's 43 out of 45. So two of the best red zone teams in the country in this game. Third down and 10. Georgia can get a first down around the three. Bennett, pressure coming. Got away from one man, and now he's going to tuck it and go with it. Got the first down. He might have the touchdown.
It was in this game a year ago that Stetson Bennett showed his legs the extra dimension. A free blitzer, and that's a touchdown. His foot was in bounds. He hit the pylon as he got hit. And that's going to be a touchdown.
They did not call it a touchdown on the field, but I'm with Gary. And he's coming right at you in our AT&T 5G pylon cam. And there goes the cam and the pylon. And now Jason Autry says we're going to go look at this. And he's telling all the coaches get off the field.
Yeah,
and the players as well.
Kirby Smart got a call from his staff up in the booth and said, we think it's a touchdown. Anything out? No.
Gene Steratore is our rules official, joining us right now for the first time. Gene?
I love starting the day being a unanimous decision with you and Gary, Brad, on this one. This is a great play. Gary squared it, nailed it. Foot inbounds, pylon hits the ball, hits the pylon, touchdown.
Jalen McCullough was the court player, our number two. Gene, look and see if you think this might be targeting on top of that, and they may lose their starting safety for Tennessee.
Yeah, as I just looked at one here, Gary, I don't think he leads enough with the crown or contacts with the crown. There's some there, but I think he's leaning with the shoulder. There is a piece of the crown there, though, on that. What they'll look at now, and we'll listen to what Jason Autry has to say, is if he is attacking with that crown of the helmet. I don't think he is, personally.
The ruling is touchdown. The runner was inbound, the first control of the ball, and he touched the pylon.
Jason Autry should have just saved that extra sentence, because as soon as he said touchdown,
yep,
93,000, well, not quite 93,000. There's some Tennessee fans
and
here.
We just heard from the truck that the replay official did look at targeting and said it was not. He agreed with Gene.
So quite a drive by Georgia. Covered 80 yards. Jack Podlesny in for the point after. Out of a Stetson Bennett hold, extra point is up and good.
Football's not hard to figure out. One team stopped them for a field goal, the other team scored a touchdown.
Stetson Bennett caps an 80-yard drive in five plays with a 13-yard touchdown run. Georgia in front, 7-3. Thursday, it's a new episode of TV's big hit comedy, Ghosts. The show critics call laugh out loud funny, delightful, and genuinely hilarious. See why folks believe in ghosts. New this Thursday after Young Sheldon on CBS. So quite an answer for Stetson Bennett and the Georgia offense after the field goal by Tennessee. Bennett hooks up with Arian Smith on a long ball down the middle, and then he caps it off himself. And we'll show you that play after this kickoff. Sails into the end zone. Tennessee will come out to the 25.
So we talked about how aggressive this Tennessee defense is. Right here is Juwan Mitchell. He is going to blitz off the edge, and he comes clean on Stetson Bennett. The blitz comes, should have a stop. Nope. Misjudges Stetson Bennett's quickness a bit. Stetson sets up the last tackler and gets it in with an athletic play. You know, we saw a little of this from Tennessee against Alabama. Remember, Bryce Young was running for his life
right
that day, made all those plays. They get there, they're just not making the plays in the backfield.
For Bennett, by the way, his sixth rushing touchdown of the year. 7-3 Georgia, and now it's Hendon Hooker's turn. Quick look left, then down the middle, and complete across the 30. His other tight end, Jacob Warren. And they go hurry up, as they always do, generally anyway, and it's right back to the same guy, and it's a first down.
See, I get a feeling on those two quick passes to start the drive, those are just to tire out the big guys up front.
Yeah, right.
Then they go, okay, you're a little tired up front? Okay, now I'll drop back and throw the ball downfield. On this play, Tennessee substituted. Another penalty by this Tennessee offensive line.
Mincy, the left tackle, jumps.
False start. Offense. 54. 5-yard penalty.
That's three right here.
You got it. I'm holding three fingers up, and we both saw the same thing.
Well, most points through eight games in SEC history. Tennessee's right in the mix.
Still just a bunch of jabs so far from this Tennessee offense.
Haven't gone with a big haymaker yet to high out of Tillman. Jabari Small broke a tackle, nice stiff arm. Still only got about three out of it, as Kamari Lassiter put the final touches on him.
And as all the people have talked all week about what could be the difference in the game, it's everything. I mean, the coaches have said that when we talked to them. A Tennessee receiver goes down. He tried to get off the field. He knew it was close. to the clock, and he just took a knee about the 30-yard line.
Jabari Small, who carried on the last play and took a pretty good hit from Lassiter, and he maybe didn't feel the effects of that until he got out there in the slot, but he'll come off, and more than likely Jalen Wright will come in for him.
He dipped his right shoulder right on the end of that play and probably took a pop, obviously, right on it. Watch him dip that right shoulder.
It was a nice tackle by Lassiter.
And then Chris Smith comes over the top and drives his shoulder into the ground again on the end of it.
So he heads to the medical tent. Small, their leading ball carrier as far as amount of carries. Had 110 coming in. Jalen Wright has more yards than he does. And Small's a better receiver out of the backfield. So a little bit of a change there. And it is Jalen Wright in his stead. Last five meetings been all Georgia. Right now they lead 7-3. Hendon Hooker is perfect, but for only 39 yards. 7 out of 7. As Gary said, 7 jabs so far. And now it's a draw play, and it's Jalen Wright. And Wright brought down. Nice way. Malachi Starks holding on for dear life to bring him down. It'll force third down.
Yeah, again, another tackle. No missed tackles so far from this Georgia defense. Athletic. 4- and 5-star players getting a chance to play for the guys that went to the NFL a year ago.
Third down at 6. Hooker. Now he's going for the knockout shot. Hyatt's out there and he overshot him. Incomplete. Fourth down.
So in last year's game, Hendon Hooker had a couple early throws that he could have produced touchdowns. He overthrew them both. He had another one right there. Remember, this is a 4-3-1 receiver, and he's throwing the ball 40 yards downfield. It's hard to overthrow these guys when they're that fast.
I thought Jalen Hyatt kind of pulled up
for me. It looked like he looked back and then go, oh, he's throwing it to me.
I thought he was shaken up a little bit. I think he got tangled up with the official back there or something. We'll have to keep our eye on that, or Jenny will for us. He was kind of limping back to the sideline. Meanwhile, it's a punt for Tennessee. And fair catch called for by Georgia. And they'll take it around the 18-yard line. So Georgia will have the ball back. And there's a little bit of a, I don't know. We'll keep you posted. 7-3 dog. Jalen Hyatt was trying to get to an overthrown ball. The field judge is right there out of bounds, and he hits the field judge's foot and turns his left ankle. And that's why he was kind of limping back to the sideline. So we'll keep our eye on him.
He's going to go from 4-3-1 to 4-3-9.
Yeah. Dejon Edwards, the backfield for Georgia. And he will get the carry. And he's going to lose yardage here. Nice job by Jeremy Banks. Tennessee's defense led by that guy, former running back turned linebacker, and he's a good one. Nico Slaughter, they moved him from safety to corner last week, and that worked pretty well against Kentucky, so he's still out there playing corner.
Just to give you a good idea how good it was, the previous four games, that Tennessee pass defense was giving up 380 yards. Against Kentucky, 98.
Yeah, a lot better, huh?
Yep.
Rough day for Will Levis last week. Just under 6 to go in the first quarter. Georgia with the lead after the touchdown on their last drive. Bennett sidearms one out to Brock Bowers. Bowers out to around the 24. Trayvon Flowers dropped him there.
So the safety Trayvon Flowers was feeling this route the whole way, but that quick release by Stetson Bennett. You know, that's one of the weapons that Stetson has. He might not be 6'4", but he gets rid of that ball extremely quick.
So third down and 4. Byron Young in that front of Tennessee will get in their track stance here.
Yeah, they're in their bare front. They usually blitz this front. And they do.
Here they come. Throw is a little bit behind the receiver, but Dominic Blaylock should have had it, I think. Kind of took his eyes off it for a moment.
Yeah, that's a little bit of miscommunication as you see Stetson Bennett. He wants that receiver to stop. When Blaylock went inside, he thought Blaylock would just stop, turn around. Remember, Stetson is reading that blitz, and he wants to get rid of the ball, and he goes, yeah, you gave me a target, and then you moved the target.
You took it away.
Yes.
So Georgia's first punt from Brett Thorson upcoming. D. Williams stands back around the 30 for Tennessee.
Oh, a rocket.
Wow. And it's still going. But is it going to make the end zone?
Oh,
it got the corner.
Goodness.
I mean the corner. Corner.
That's a 75-yard punt.
At the one. 75 yards, as Gary said. My friend Cam Nyzelek's got a big smile on his face right now.
Holy
Georgia punter.
How?
You can't do it any better than
that. No.
Wow.
That's a game ball punt if this turns out the way you expect it for this Georgia defense.
You talk about flipping the field. From our AT&T 5G pylon cam, you saw it go out at the 1 yard line. Now it's time for Do Project Smarter, presented by the Home Depot. Put together a player named Josh Heupel out of Aberdeen, South Dakota, by way of junior college to Oklahoma. And then he knows a little bit about offense to turn him into a coach.
Ran the same offense, and when we told him we were going to run this clip, he goes, was I throwing off my back foot? We go, yes, you were. But second year, they won a championship. He's running a very similar offense, and Josh is in his second year. Can he duplicate this? Let's put it this way. He's got a chance.
Got a chance. 8-0, but right now backed up inside their own 1 yard line, courtesy of Brett Thorson's rocket of a punt, the 10th longest in Georgia football history. Jalen Wright in the end zone with Hendon Hooker. He'll get the carry. And he got him a little bit more room to breathe, almost to the 5. Jamon Dumas Johnson, inside linebacker, made the tackle. And Jalen Hyatt is on the sideline. Whether he's hurt or not, we're going to keep our eye on him. And Wright's going down after a 1 yard gain. It'll be third down. Malachi Starks. Let's go to Jenny.
You see Jalen Hyatt running in right now. He did step on a ref's foot, twisted that ankle a little bit, came off. He spoke with a couple of coaches before. Going back into Hendon Hooker's huddle with the offense, I'm told he's going to be fine. And Jabari Small, guys, history with a bad shoulder. It's an upper body injury. He is available, but he's still on the sideline.
All right, Jenny, thanks. So Hyatt back in there in the slot to Hooker's right. And the crowd is trying to make it as difficult as possible on Hooker down at the goal line. From his own end zone. He waited too long, and down he goes. And it's going to be a safety.
Did the ball get out, though? I think it might have been recovered by Tennessee.
Jalen Carter punched it out of there.
Now they're going to decide, was the ball rolling forward? Where was it when it was recovered?
Tennessee already has their punting unit out there.
It's always tough to lose a great player in Nolan Smith, but trade for Jalen Carter, that inside pass rush was a factor. He gets his arm. It's a fumble. It's picked up. It's fumbled again at the line. Did the offensive lineman get out of the end zone? Was his knee down? I think it's Spragans, number 76. Now, was his knee down before he gets out?
As the quarterback lost possession of the ball in the end zone, it was recovered by the offense and advanced to the half yard beyond the goal line. It is fourth down.
This should be reviewed, though, because Javonta Spragans' knee may have come down in the end zone.
Before he stretched that ball out.
Exactly.
And Gene's with us as well.
Easy call on the fumble. I'm sorry, Gene, go ahead.
No worries, Gary. I think the fumble, I agree. I don't believe that's a forward pass. He's bringing the ball back. So I've got Hookers with a fumble. What I see here is I feel, guys, if he still has maintained possession of that ball, that he is down before that football. And let's remember, that entire football must get back in the field of play in order for it to be in the field of play and not a safety. And in my opinion, when that O lineman gets recovery there and starts to be getting tackled, that football is not clearly out of the end zone, and that would result in a safety.
Yeah, I think his knee came down as he was leaning forward, even before he came down. His knee is down now, before the play and the ball gets even to be close to the line. So I'll bet this thing is overturned for 2 points.
So they'll send it upstairs to Bryant Thompson again.
Not often you see a fumble, offensive guard run with the ball, another fumble, and then a recovery. But his down right there before he stretches the ball out. I know I would, if I was the replay official, I would overturn it and make it a safety.
Chaz Chambliss was holding on for dear life, trying to bring down a 340-pounder who turned offensive lineman into fullback, just trying to get that thing back across the line. We don't think he did, but it's now up to Bryant Thompson and Jason Autry.
I'm wondering if Josh Heupel tries to challenge that, whether this is a forward pass. You know, if I'm Josh Heupel, I'm trying everything, anything I can right now,
yeah.
Right? I mean, that's another thing they have to look for here.
Remember, Jalen Carter, number 88 there on the right side of your screen, was hurt on the first snap of the Oregon game this year, and they finally got him back last week and played quite a few third down snaps, and today he's causing disruption in the middle of that offensive line for Tennessee.
One more look at the original fumble. Was his hand coming forward? Gene thought not. I think not. I think it was a fumble.
So the discussion continues. Remember, if this is a safety, you can give the 2 points to Brett Thorson, who hit the 75-yard rocket punt that went out inside the one-yard line.
Totally. I don't know. I didn't think it was coming forward.
I
really
either.
Don't. Going back, gets hit. To me, he never came out. Came forward at all.
And now we'll take you right down the line on the recovery. It's a long ways, but there's the ball out courtesy of Jalen Carter. There's the scoop. And now we think that a lot of that 340 pounds was already on the turf before the ball got across the line, but this is taking a long time to check this out. It's a very important play, obviously. It's either going to be 2 points for Georgia or it's going to be a punt for Tennessee with a short end zone for their kicker.
You saw Josh signaling. He thought it was a pass.
As you said, he's going to think everything he can.
Absolutely.
This might be one look that we haven't had.
Boy, I don't see it. I don't. Yeah.
All right, Gene, we'll bring you back in.
Yeah, I think the other portion, they know that if this is a fumble, they feel fine with the safety. They're focusing right where we are. I think the other piece they may be looking at is if they deem that to be a forward pass or the arm moving forward, is it going backward? So is it a backward pass if they rule in their judgment that the arm or the hand's coming forward? Is it going in a backward direction and not forward as well?
So a backward pass would equal a fumble, though. Ball would be live.
Correct. Yes.
You know, we always get frustrated for taking the time with these replays. This one's worth it.
I'm staying out of it. I call it a safety to start with, so I'm going to back away. We'll let Jason Autry tell us.
After video review, the ruling on the field stands. Fourth down.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, all right. It's a punting situation then.
Oh, my goodness. That was the least likely, in my opinion, to tell you the truth.
That would have been about my third choice.
Yes. Yeah, Kirby goes, his left knee is down before he gets to the line. And as Gene said, the whole football has to get out.
Paxton Brooks backed up to his own end line.
And who knows how this is going to work out, though. This type of punt from this close could produce bad results still for Tennessee.
Georgia might even come after it.
Oh, yeah. Catch and punt.
Brooks, quick kick, got it out. McConkie calls fair catch, and he's going to take it around the 37-yard line. So great field position for Georgia. They don't get the 2 points. And the fans are still not happy. Our aerial coverage of today's game is brought to you by Goodyear. And that's the only shot we didn't give you of that last play from the blimp. We had every other one covered, pretty much. So a little bit of relief for Tennessee, well, but not so much when they're finding Georgia at the 37-yard line.
Now remember, the Georgia defense answered the bell with the early turnover in the game and forced a field goal. It's the Tennessee's defense turn right now. They need to at least hold this Georgia offense to a field goal.
Dejon Edwards behind Stetson Bennett, who's under center with Brock Bowers, the motion man. Play fake. Bennett loads it. Fires to the end zone. McConkie, touchdown. One play, six more points for Georgia.
It's called an out and up. You get a receiver playing one-on-one coverage. First down touchdown. Watch it. Just a little wiggle and he's gone. A little wiggle and he's gone. Easy throw. Perfect call. Take advantage of the team that's reeling. Sudden change. Make them pay for it.
Now the chance of UGA. As Podlesny's in for the point after. They add to their lead. To the pylon, to the end zone, to McConkie from Bennett. Touchdown, Georgia. Well, McConkie had one last week against Florida. He's got another one today. 37-yard strike from Stetson Bennett. And Georgia leads 14-3.
A walk-on with all these five stars throws it to an under-recruited two-star for a touchdown. All set up by a punter that probably didn't have a scholarship either.
And Tennessee will work from the 25. Take you back to the last series and how it all came to be.
Look at D. Williams. He's expected to punt on the 30-yard line. Okay, you expect your punt returner to catch it, but it sails all the way to the 17. He feels it's a hard catch. He lets it go, and it turns out right there. That set up the whole sequence. And this, we thought Georgia's arguing for 2 points. The call ended up giving them 7 points.
Then a short punt, and then they said, we'll take the six instead.
And the big plays, who we thought would be coming from the Tennessee side of the field, has been coming from the Georgia side of the field. The longest play for Tennessee in the game, 7 yards.
First down at the 25. Cedric Tillman in motion. And Jalen Wright gets the edge, and there's a 10-yard gain and a first down. Now Tennessee will be going with their tempo. They average about 3 plays a minute. They've got a first down just across the 35. Hooker waiting. Now trying to buy himself some time. He keeps it. And he gets something out of it. Picked up about 4.
As you said, and then Hooker was waiting and waiting. That means that secondary for Georgia, nowhere to go with the football.
Second down and 8 from the 38. They'll keep it on the ground. And a pickup of about 3. Third down coming up. No first quarter touchdowns in the last 13 games. Tennessee, the last one to get one. And they've got 2.5 minutes to try to change that statistic. Third and 5. Hooker. Hit as he threw. And it took a hop, I think, to Hyatt, didn't it?
I don't think Hyatt thought he caught it, that's for sure.
And they're going to have to punt it away again.
So remember, just think about this Tennessee offense, how explosive they've been. Not only have they not been able to drive the ball, remember, this is an offense that scores every other time they get the ball.
Right.
touchdowns, not field goals. The Georgia defense has been impeccable so far.
It's been Georgia-like so far.
That's a good way to put it.
Brooks to punt. We got close to him. High tallywagger going down, and McConkie, he was hit as he tried to make the fair catch. He obviously made the fair catch signal, and then he got hit. So that's going to be a penalty on Tennessee.
And, you know, this is really the first game, you know, so all the way to this point, this Tennessee has been building. They've been hunting. They've been trying to climb that ladder. This is the first game where the spotlight's been on them.
Yep.
You know, Georgia, Alabama, Clemson, Ohio State.
Kind of used to it.
Yeah. You could feel they feel tenser in this game just watching them play.
And those first two or three false start penalties didn't help them either.
Yep. But another silly mistake right there. I mean, you can't get that close when a guy's signaling fair catch.
William Wright, the guilty party. And so Georgia's field position is going to improve from that fair catch out around the 35, I think, maybe the 36, right in there. And they're spotted at the 36. Georgia with touchdowns, one by their quarterback running, one by their quarterback throwing on a one-play drive the last time they had it. Branson Robinson in the backfield, and he'll get the carry. Pushes ahead for maybe a yard. That's it.
You know, Ness, the stereotypes of what these teams are sometimes doesn't fit it. Kirby, you think, is a running ball control team. Which team do you think has run it more this year? Actually, it's been Tennessee. 347 to 286. Which team has thrown it more this year? Georgia. 300 pass attempts to 251 for Tennessee.
Just not the perception
and
everybody
boom,
has.
Boom, it's blowing it up. Yep. Right? It is.
Georgia 107 passing yards already. Kenny McIntosh checks back in with Bennett in the Georgia backfield. Second down and 9. Bennett. Going to go deep again. Kenny McIntosh out of the backfield and on the run. All the way down inside the 15. Another chunk play.
It's called the wheel route. Kenny McIntosh is their best wide, their running back receiver against Oregon in the opening game. He had 9 catches for 117 yards. This time they set him up on the wheel route, and he runs right by it. And you don't want to overthrow that. I get it. A perfect pass is a touchdown, but you hate an incompletion when you get a 40-yard chunk play.
49 in that case to the 14. Back in the red zone. Georgia up 14-3 and looking for more. Toss sweep to McIntosh. Darnell Washington out in front blocking, and he'll be run out of bounds around the 6 by Tank McCullough.
Ness went down on the field, and I don't think on TV you can just get the feel of how big Darnell Washington is.
Mammoth.
He is like a huge offensive tackle. Look at Bowers next to him. Bowers is 6'4". He's 6'7". Huge. He's like a tackle tight end. So they really have 6 offensive linemen, one of them that can really catch the ball.
Both of them just shifted from the right side to the left side. From the 7-yard line, second down and 3. Dejon Edwards going to have a first down, I think. Forward progress got him to the 4, which is where they needed to get. First down and goal. And the fans on the other end of the field are really going to be happy, because that first and goal is going to come down there in the left end zone. It's coming your way, gang. We played 1, and the defending national champions so far think maybe they should be number 1. Well, they are in a couple of polls. 15 minutes in, Georgia 14, Tennessee 3. Home Depot SEC on CBS brings us into quarter number 2. Our aerial coverage, including those shots from our drone, brought to you by Goodyear. Up quickly at the 4-yard line, first and goal. Toss Kenny McIntosh, and he's dropped for a loss.
Yeah, he bobbled the ball, and I don't think he ever got his momentum going. with the quick play. Quick huddle, sugar huddle, tried to catch him and go wide. Watch him bobble the balls, and then he really didn't get going again. This is a situation they really, Todd Monken loves to go to his tight ends here. Bowers and Washington.
Right now, Washington is on the right side, Bowers on the left, and now they both split out a little bit farther in their respective directions on second down and goal from the five. Bennett looks left, goes high. Touchdown! Rosemary Jack Saint in the very back of the end zone.
See if he got 1 foot down.
He got 2 foot down.
That's all you need. And you're taught when you throw the ball to the end zone, just keep it just under the crossbar. Okay, your guy goes up. These guys can all go up and get it. Watch it. Just under the crossbar, and that's how they catch it.
There's a beautiful shot right there. 5 yard touchdown pass. Bennett's second touchdown pass in as many series.
And if you watch Stetson Bennett there, he looked left, right, and then back left. Give a little bit to that offensive line holding that pass rush out that time.
Absolutely. Todd Lesney in for the point after. And it hits the upright, doesn't it?
Skinned it in.
It skimmed in. Close, but still good. Marcus Rosemary Jack Saint doing a little dance over there on the bench. First, Stetson Bennett. He's got some moves as well. Second touchdown pass for him. It's 21-3. Well, 64-yard drive and 6 plays. And Georgia in front 21-3.
Does appear that this Tennessee secondary is earning their reputation as the 127th ranked pass defense in college football.
Yeah, they give up over 300 yards a game. They're going to have that by halftime, maybe. Let's go back to our New York studios for a Heisman watch presented by Nissan.
Yeah, and it's time for Hendon Hooker to get his going today. And what would a quarterback's Heisman campaign be without a touchdown reception? Bo Nix bringing one in for Oregon. They're all over Colorado 21-7 as he adds that to his season stats. C.J. Stroud in the elements at Northwestern. More rushing yards than passing today as the second-ranked Buckeyes get past Northwestern 21-7. Back to you.
All right, Zook, thanks.
You know who's been quiet? No called running plays for Hendon Hooker. It's hard to keep the spread going if you don't run the quarterback against Georgia.
He only ran once, and that wasn't by design. Here he's set to throw. Maybe. No, he won't. Sacked.
Coverage sack again.
Waltauer got to him.
Hendon Hooker looks play action wide right, middle right, nowhere to go. Waltauer from behind.
Georgia was last in the conference coming into this one in sacks. They're getting a lot of pressure on Hendon Hooker. Jabari Small is back in at tailback. They fake it to him and throw the out the other way, but just a short gain again to Brew McCoy, his first reception.
So you can tell this Georgia defense understands what Tennessee's trying to do to them. They're running full speed, trying to go deep, and if it's not there, the choice is to come right back down towards the quarterback.
And un-Tennessee-like first quarter, as you saw that graphic, more punts and mistakes than anything else. Hooker on a crossing route, incomplete, intended for his tight end, and there comes a late flag. Jacob Warren was the intended receiver.
I think, was it Christopher Smith that time, 29, that was in the cover?
I think so.
Wholesale changes. Replenish that defensive line with all fresh bodies.
Holding defense, number 22. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. It moves automatic to first down.
They call it on Javon Bullard, the safety. So that'll give Tennessee a first down out across the 40. It was on Bullard on high.
It wasn't on the player that he threw to. It was on the middle of the field.
Right. Well, they're making some.
How about trying to figure out a way to get the ball to Cedric Tillman a little bit? Now, number 4, prior to the explosion by Hyatt. He was the go-to receiver.
Keep it on the ground, and about a 2-yard gain for Jabari Small. And Bullard, the guy that had the penalty, make the tackle.
You know, under the Josh Heupel offense in 2 years at Tennessee, three times he's been slowed down in the run game, and he struggled in all three games.
Here's a quick throw out to Hyatt, looking for a blocker, and only picked up a couple yards.
In 2021, Alabama held him to 65 yards rushing. Same year, last year, Georgia held him to 55, and this year, Pitt held Tennessee to 91, and that game went overtime.
Right.
So without the running game, you know, that defense for Georgia has slowed down the pass game.
That last catch was Brew McCoy, not Jalen Hyatt. Third down and 5. Down the middle, and good throw and catch. Jacob Warren, first down to the tight end.
No other way to do it if you're the Tennessee offense. You got to take what this defense is giving you right now. They're peeling back a bit, giving you the short throw. You got to force them to cover short. And one more look at this. Can he control it? Too late now. Hurry up, got it away.
They got the handoff to Small before anybody could look at it. He picked up 3.
Is it caught? Good coverage.
Got his hands around it. Georgia defender, you got a red and black glove, and you got 2 orange gloves.
I think that was a catch. That ball didn't move. It touched the ground, but didn't wobble.
Second down and 8.
If you're Alex Golas right now, I wonder if they're already thinking 4 down territory.
Blitz coming. Tennessee picks it up. Hooker trying to deliver it to Tillman, and now we got another flag on Georgia. This one's going to be on Keely Ringo.
Okay, so they've been on those short throws, right? That's 3 of them right in a row. So now
holding,
you got to see that.
Defense number 5. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. It commits an automatic touchdown.
So 2 first downs for Tennessee by Georgia penalty.
Yeah, and you could see Ringo. He actually pulled the jersey even before the ball got there.
Michael Williams, I think, is the guy that's down for Georgia. And as they help him to his feet, we'll take a quick break. CBS Sports embraces authentic stories. Share yours at hashtag my native story. 11:23 remaining first half. Tennessee with a couple of Georgia penalties has a first down at the 33. Throw by Hooker, caught by Tillman. He reverses field, and this is what he does so well. After he catches and wheels, he's got that big body, and he's got another first down.
So as the Georgia offense have had long passes of 52, 49, and 37, before that catch, the longest completion by Tennessee was 9 yards. That's now their longest completion.
Now they're in the red zone. They got to be, as Gary said, thinking touchdown, not field goal, that's for sure. Hooker, quarterback draw this time. And got a pretty good gain out of it. Took a whack when he got there by Starks. And now they'll hustle back to the line.
So all year, this Georgia defense in the red zone has only allowed 4 touchdowns all year.
Jalen Wright got a couple more yards.
As teams have been there 14 times, 4 touchdowns, 5 field goals, and then the rest stop.
Tennessee averages about 3.3 passing touchdowns a game. Georgia's
oh, another one.
5 all year.
Another penalty. That's 4 pre-snap penalties.
False start. Offense. 58. 5-yard penalty. They start down.
And this offensive line for Tennessee is a veteran bunch.
Yeah, they are.
This time I think it's right, number 58. Yep, that's what starts it. And they don't, if you don't think that that crowd is a factor in college football, to these young guys, they're trying to do all that communication. This is really, I know they played at LSU. That's an 11 a.m. game. This is a much louder atmosphere for this Tennessee offense.
Third down and 7.
So there's
another flag.
There is nothing that Georgia is showing. For 3 years, when you turn on tape against Georgia, their defensive line has a late shift. It's been gone over and over and over again with this offensive line, and they forced another penalty. We've been watching it for 5 years, 4 years, and look at a little bit of miscommunication, and then that causes another 5-yard penalty.
Now they're almost out of the red zone, back at the 19. Blitz coming. Hooker stands in over the middle, incomplete, intended for his tight end and broken up by Javon Bullard.
But Javon Bullard is kind of a slot corner safety player. Played all spring, a lot of corner training for him to get him ready to handle these slot plays. And this time he felt very comfortable with the tight end in front of him.
Josh Heupel wants to get points out of this no matter what it is. So Chase McGrath comes in.
7-man blitz from the Georgia defense on that last play.
36-yard field goal attempt for McGrath, who hit from 47 earlier, and this one's up and perfect.
So the turnover early, they force a field goal. A good drive again, forcing a field goal. Georgia defense feels good about themselves.
They consider that a win, 21-6. All right, Zuck, reminder for you, tonight at 7 Eastern on CBS Sports Network, get ready for some action in the Mountain West. Rebels and Aztecs both look to bounce back and score their fifth win of the season. That's 7 Eastern tonight on CBS Sports Network. Paxton Brooks, the punter and kickoff man. Kyaris Jackson for Georgia, waiting back around the 5-yard line. That drive by Tennessee took 11 plays to go 56 yards and had to settle for 3. And fair catch called for at the goal line. Georgia will come out to the 25.
So I don't know what Tennessee's defense can do because it's been going too good.
Well, now it's time for our hometown connection presented by T-Mobile. Here's Jenny.
Brad, after you win the national championship, you see everyone celebrating by kissing the trophy. Well, that was just the beginning of the celebration tour for Stetson Bennett. The Georgia native, he went up to receive the key to the city in his hometown of Blackshear. He flew with the Blue Angels. Stetson said he could hardly walk after that experience. They pulled 7.4 Gs. And this past summer, he studied abroad in Europe, where him and his classmates got to visit the Coliseum. And as you can see, my favorite of them all, Poppel Farms in Odom, Georgia. They made a corn maze of him.
It's good being Stetson right now. And so far in this half, it has been as well. Quick throw to Bowers. And Brock Bowers taking some Tennessee balls with him, and the Georgia offense helping push him very close to a first down.
You know, this Georgia offense changed when Kirby Smart hired Todd Monken. Right there, red hat, looking right at you. Look how quickly he's calling that next play. He has retooled this offense. They were just a pound and ground type team before. Now they line up with 2 tight ends. In fact, 6 out of 10 plays they use 2 tight ends. But one of them is a hybrid. And that makes this offense really, really tough to stop. From inside out, he's got this Tennessee defense turned inside out.
And Tennessee has not defended tight ends well this year. And then when you're talking about this group that Georgia has, it's not a good combo. They stop Bowers short of the first. Second down at 1 yard. They get the yard and about 3 more. First down, Georgia. For Dejon Edwards. Dejon coming off a big game last week. Career high at over 100 yards and a couple of touchdowns in the win over Florida. And Stetson Bennett's numbers today had really only 1 pass that hit Jeremy Banks right in the chest. Exactly. Other than that, everything else been pretty good.
Condensed trips, you know, versus the wide splits of Tennessee.
Right, what a difference, huh?
Yep.
They fake the end around. Bennett loads, goes long. And he outshot everybody. Arian Smith was the intended receiver, who he hooked up with in the first quarter on a long ball.
But you do like that they continue to remind this Tennessee defense, we're going to continue. You play man, we're going to continue to go deep balls. Great coverage at time by Tonnage on that play. He actually was in pretty good phase on the one that was completed. It was just a perfect ball.
Especially when he grabbed his jersey. That was great.
Slight. You get away with that. He's kind of went for a ride with it.
Yeah, basically. Now Georgia a little more split out with their receiving core. Four across, two of the tight ends. They'll keep it on the ground anyway to Robinson.
Good defense, good stop.
Jeremy Banks with a tackle.
So far in the game, as we watch this run and this Georgia defense so good against the run, Tennessee defense so good against the run. They're second in the SEC in rushing against them. It's tough yardage against this veteran group of that defense in front seven.
They only give up 93 yards a game on the ground.
Yeah, but in the air, there's more. Right?
That's the problem. Third down and nine. Georgia will have to earn this one. Kenny McIntosh back in the Georgia backfield. We know what he can do as a receiver out of that backfield. And we're going to have a false start on Georgia.
False start. Offense, number 19, 5-yard penalty, third down.
You just get the feeling if you're Josh Heupel right here, you're going, guys, if we could get a stop and one touchdown, this 21-6 could be 21-14 very easy, right? Mm-hmm.
Can't get it all back at once.
Nope. But, they could, one little, those Georgia defenders are squatting a bit, a little shake and go. They need the stop here, though. Georgia's been 2-for-3 on third down.
This is a big one. Third and 14. Quick throw out in the flat. And it's going to be punting situation. Kiaris Jackson, a little wide out screen, but McCullough had that in his sights. And he makes the tackle. And Georgia will have to kick it. One of their best weapons of the day, though, is that guy, Brett Thorson. This is going to be, he'll be around his 25 to kick it.
Yeah, D. Williams has his heels on the 10. He should not back up.
This one way shorter. It's going to take a hop and a Tennessee bounce.
Yeah, that's great field position for this Tennessee offense. They were expecting that ball 10 or 15 yard line.
6:41 remaining in a half. Tennessee trailing, but their offense has got it back with good field position when we return. Back in 2008, a statue of former Georgia head coach and athletic director Vince Dooley was dedicated. It overlooks the athletic department on the southwest part of campus. Coach Dooley passed away a week ago yesterday. Charlie Trippi, maybe considered the greatest athlete Georgia's ever had, passed away about a week before that at age 100. Coach Dooley was 90 years old, and they have adorned the sidelines here. Charlie Trippi, they've got a sticker helmet on Georgia and his signature down one side. Line and Vince Dooley down the other sideline. Vince had a winning record against Tennessee. And by the way, when he took over the Georgia program, Sanford Stadium held 36,000 people. Today we got 93 here. As the sun shines on the Tennessee balls on their end of the field, trailing 21-6. Hendon Hooker got it to Cedric Tillman. Tillman still running. And he's going to pick up about 17 before Georgia can track him down.
Last series, I asked if they could start getting the ball to Tillman. I felt they established him a bit. Maybe they could make that the pressure point, and then Hyatt will open up from there.
First down from the 48. Jalen Wright spins his way into Georgia territory and flips forward close to the 45.
Great patience that time by Wright. He just stuttered his feet, waited, and as you see, it has not been pretty for this offense that's used to scoring every other time they get the ball.
Field goal bookends around three punts. And another first down run.
Yeah, I also think that right now that this offense has to give their defense a blow as well. Okay, they finally got a stop. This hurry-up offense sometimes gets them back on the field too fast. They need to bleed it a little bit, and it's just short.
Well, they didn't give him the first down. Third down at about a foot. Hooker under center. Into the middle of that pile. I don't think Jalen Wright got there, but let's wait and see.
I think Robert Beal, number 33, was the first guy to get back there inside. almost, I think, Bullard as well coming off the edge, and they didn't make it. See Bullard and Beal on the inside.
They didn't even think about measuring. It's fourth down. Here's a must-have, and with that, Hooker runs it, and that helps their cause when he's moving like that.
Now they'll go fast, get a first down, get another first down, get a chance now to run their whole offense.
First down at the 39 of Georgia. Hooker going to go long to the near corner to Tillman, and it's intercepted by Keely Ringo.
What a job by Keely Ringo, because Cedric Tillman is very physical. Watch these two athletes fight all the way down the field, pushing, shoving, staying in phase, turning around, finding the ball, and making a wonderful play. You just don't do it any better than that. It was a fight for 40 yards, and Ringo won.
The hero of the national championship game with a 79-yard interception return to seal it, and the win over Alabama just sealed Tennessee off here late in the second quarter.
Yes.
I know how you feel, Zook. Keely Ringo just sealed off Tennessee's last drive with an interception in the end zone, and having some words from his head coach on the sideline.
Yeah, you get challenged. Remember, they ran the slant on him. Then they came back with the deep ball. Makes sense. You get your best player matched up man-to-man, and their guy wins.
Kendall Milton's in the Georgia backfield. We really weren't sure we'd see him today. First time he's been out with a groin problem since being injured against Auburn. And they're going to let him have it right here. And he looks hungry. Picked up five.
So Stetson Bennett has been hitting the big balls in this football game, going deep, one-on-one to Arian Smith early. But this touchdown throw late, his last one, look what he was going to throw the ball. He was stopping right here. He's going to have to throw the ball right over the head of the defender, McCullough. That's a gutsy throw. If that one's a half a foot lower, the whole 82,000 people are going, Stetson, what are you doing? Threw it right over the top of him.
Edwards now comes in after Milton had one carry. Second down and five. Georgia has all its timeouts and still 4 minutes and change remaining here in the quarter. Edwards straight up the middle. Into the secondary, still going all the way out to the 45-yard line.
Now leading rusher on this team, he has really been coming on strong the last four games. Devin Willick, number 77, back in the game. He gets another key block, and inside, it's handled by Ratledge and Van Pran. The offensive line for Georgia is opening some holes. Plenty of time.
20-yard pickup for
patient.
Edwards.
Patient. They can be patient with the offense. Everything available.
And now Edwards trots out as a receiver to the top of your screen. Empty backfield for Stetson Bennett. First down at the 45. Bennett takes a short route across the middle, and it's going to be close to a first down to Rosamie Jack Saints.
Stetson Bennett here, great protection. He wants to go to Brock Bowers down the middle of the field. He gets high-low coverage, so he comes off of him and then waits for the guy coming into the middle. Beautiful job.
Now the throw out to Edwards out of the backfield. Made one man miss, got tripped up.
What a play.
Boy, he got that corner, and he might still be running, but nice play by Slaughter over there to get just a piece of his foot. Tripped him up.
Yeah, I think he had about another 6-7 yards at least if he didn't trip him up.
Still first down at the Tennessee 42.
Here comes the power inside by Robinson now, number 22, the freshman. It's like having seven offensive linemen left side at least with Washington's like an extra tackle. Bowers not as good, but pretty good.
And nice job by Tennessee's defense. Robinson stopped for a loss.
Yeah, the two linebackers that time, both Mitchell and Banks, read that quickly, catch it into the backfield. Again, veteran players recognizing the play. Banks, Mitchell, they see it. Nobody catches them this time. Both of them in on the tackle.
Tennessee player down. Latrell Bumpus down on one knee. That's the second time he's been shaken up here in the first half. Coca-Cola. 5th-year senior Latrell Bumpus holding his rib cage area. He's heading into the medical tent. Coming up on the Geico Halftime Report, Adam, Rick, and BJ will break down the first half and bring you highlights from around the country on the Geico Halftime Report.
Project Jones was just singing, turn the music down. I don't know if
you... And they do.
And they do.
So 3 runs, a couple of passes. Georgia in this 3-minute drive. All the time in the world as they've got 2nd down and 10 at the Tennessee 43. Bennett throws complete. McConkie, 1st down and more.
And I tell you what, when you climb that pocket and you have ability to go into that, instead of running, you got a quarterback that wants to throw the ball. That's ingrained in Stetson Bennett. He's not a scramble first guy. He wants to make those throws. And, you know, that pass rush that time and the offensive line pushed him by. He waited for McConkie. Paid off.
1st down at the 25 with 21 points and looking for more here before halftime.
Love the way they're bleeding the clock here. They have 3 timeouts. They don't want to give it back to Tennessee at all.
Kenny McIntosh back at the tailback spot will get the handle right in the middle of things and only about 2 yards. That's it. Now we're under a minute. And Georgia's going to take one of their timeouts with 51 seconds remaining in the half. We'll be back in 30 seconds. This one, obviously Georgia and Tennessee tied on top. Georgia's got a game in hand. And so it's the battle for the top spot here and a big one in the West tonight. Alabama at Death Valley against LSU. And Ole Miss's idol will see them next week against the Tide.
It's been a while in the SEC since the feature game has been on the east side.
That's right. Yeah, this has been built up as the biggest thing in a long, long time. The biggest game in this stadium's history. And so far for Georgia, they've lived up to it.
Yeah, and Todd Monken has this Tennessee defense guessing who's going to get the ball. Could be 5 different guys.
On 2nd and 9, Bennett throws a little bit behind Rosalie Jack Saint, but he took it off his hip pad and completes it. But it's still going to be 3rd down and about 4. As we work our way down near a half minute or less.
Watch out for McIntosh on this play.
Kirby's even on the sideline going, take your time, take your time. You can see him right on the bottom of your screen with his palms down. And then a little jump pass to McConkie, and he's inside the 10. 1st down Georgia with 12 seconds left.
They tried the wheel route to McIntosh to the outside. Covered well by Tennessee. Climbed the pocket, and as Ness said, a little jump pass, get it out of bounds. So they probably have time for 3 plays here.
It sits right at the 10-yard line where it's 1st and goal. That part doesn't really even matter right now.
Quick throw here. You want a quick throw so you can use 3 plays. Fade to the end zone that takes 3 or 4 seconds. That would give you 3 plays.
Empty backfield as McIntosh comes out to join Rosalie Jack Saint down to the bottom left side. The other 3 receivers to the right. Tennessee corner blitz. Quick throw to Gary Call. McIntosh down to the 2.
Timeout. All right. See, with 7 seconds now, you can still get 2 plays, and you also, because 2 timeouts, can still run the ball. Quick throw, slant. Kirby's running down the field right there. Watch him call a timeout at the bottom of the screen.
Pretty good speed.
Yep. Well. Let's put it this way. Kirby would not recruit Kirby. Okay.
Never heard it put that way before. So 7 seconds remaining in the half. College football poll that came out this week. Tennessee number 1, Ohio State number 2, Georgia in the 3 slot. For most of the season, Georgia's been number 1 in both the AP and the coaches poll. They're still there, number one with Tennessee, number two. So we really got a battle of number one against number one.
We do, and we're pretty sure whoever wins the game obviously will be number one after. But doesn't it really feel that Georgia's way more comfortable in this game? It just feels like they've been here before. They played in more big games. Just a little bit new for this Tennessee team.
And they don't have to deal with the noise in here at all. Home field definitely showing up for Georgia so far today. And they're one or two plays away from tacking on more points unless something strange happens.
The interesting thing is, after the first play, do you take the 3 points or do you use two plays and try to score on both if you don't score on the first one? That'll be Kirby's decision after this if they don't score. Does he take three or does he try to score with two plays?
Kendall Milton in the backfield with Stetson Bennett. He switches sides. Bowers down to the bottom of your screen. It's a rollout by Bennett and a throw to the corner, and it's broken up. Incomplete. And it was Slaughter.
So now he's going to take field. He's going to take points. With it being 21-6, he wants to get to 24, doesn't he?
I think they're bringing in extra bodies. Let's wait and see.
I think they're.
Now they got the field goal unit out there.
Yeah, but they've got Stetson still in the game.
Well, he's the holder.
Yeah, I thought they were going to go offense. All right, there you go.
So this is should be.
So all the time they were kind of conserving actually cost them another play.
A little bit.
I mean,
yeah.
You know, it's here nor there. You never know. But in retrospect, they'd love to have one more.
So short field goal of 19 yards is up and good, and that will end the half.
And that'll make it a three-score game, which is what Kirby said to Stetson. Stay away. I'm taking the points.
Quite a performance by the defending national champs against a Heisman hopeful and the number one team in the college football poll. But in the first half, it's all Georgia.
Got to hand to that Georgia defense as well, though. I mean, the offense we know has been humming all year, but that defense to stop Tennessee to 6 points, amazing first half.
No doubt. And Jenny's with Josh Heupel.
Coach, how do you generate some offense in the second half?
Yeah, well, we got to do the little things right. Obviously, a bunch of self-inflicted wounds early in the football game. We got to be more precise in what we're doing, communication. Got to clean some things up to get the ball moving.
You said that this team believes that they can beat anyone in this country. What's going to be your message to them at the half to remind them of that?
At the end of the day, we got to reset. We got to go play one play at a time. We got to make some plays to get back in the football game. 30 more minutes of football. Let's go play.
Good luck, Coach.
So, first half has come to a close. Georgia, pretty impressive at home. They lead 24-6 at the end of the half as we send you to Adam Zucker in our New York studio for the Geico Halftime Report. Zucker. The Home Depot SEC on CBS brings us into quarter number three at Dooley Field at Sanford Stadium in Athens, Georgia. With the lead, Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jenny Dell down on the field. Well, a couple hours ago, we said there's always variables involved. We talked about Georgia's defense being so good. Hendon Hooker's a Heisman Trophy candidate. Stetson Bennett's a guy that looks like he's trying to win a Heisman here.
You know, I think Stetson is controlling the football game. His coaches believe in him. And I think an early play in this half really led to a lot of good things for this Georgia offense. When he scrambled early, that was a big difference. Tennessee, remember, in that situation, it was third and long. And defensive coordinator Tim Banks for Tennessee dialed a clean blitz. Stetson evades it. And from then on, he didn't have much pressure, led to a touchdown. And then I think the second big play was the punt. That just really changed the whole tenor of the football game.
Yeah.
A 75-yarder to the one, it seemed to really discombobulate the Tennessee team.
And then after the near safety, the short punt, Georgia takes one play, and Bennett hooks up with McConkey for another touchdown. And that's where we're sitting right now, 24-6.
And right now, Tennessee says, this is the drive we had to have.
No doubt. And they're going to keep it on the ground for the first couple yards of it. And Jalen Wright. And Jalen Wright popped out of there. Jalen Wright, I don't know how he got out of that pack. And he gets up to the 40. But was the whistle blown?
I thought it was. I thought I heard one. Yep.
Yeah, they're bringing it back.
Stuffed inside. You know, this defensive line lost a lot of talent. They're holding up fine.
Here's a quick throw. Jalen Hyatt, who's been not really a factor, going to get a first down, I think. And they're trying to go fast, and now Georgia's got a guy down. And that's Robert Beal, and they can't afford to lose him because they don't have Nolan Smith already, and he's playing that spot.
They've got a lot of highly recruited players that line up now as backups, but they're young freshmen.
Yeah. Marvin Johnson Jr. and some of those guys would come in and probably play that spot. Chaz Chambliss also hopefully just got the wind knocked out of him or took a low shot. But it's going to be third down and a yard, less than a yard.
Interesting on that Georgia team from a year ago, the national championship team that was so good on defense. It was actually Beal who led the team
in sacks. Yeah, that's right. Just to the left of the blue line. Well, he got hit before that. And Duluth, Georgia's senior.
It's right here is where he is. Takes on a block, then he turns to run, and then he seems to feel it as he's running. Something ain't right. Yeah. He goes down to one knee.
Yeah, he took a block from Warren, the tight end.
Yeah.
So we'll see if he's able to return. And it's third down and less than a yard. Jalen Hyatt thought that he got the yard, but he didn't. He's about a foot or two shy. First half trends. You probably know this part if you've been watching the game. Three total touchdowns, two in the air, one on the ground for Bennett. Hendon Hooker has struggled without a doubt this worst half of the year so far. And Tennessee's offense leading the nation at over 49 a game. And they've got two field goals to show for it here early third quarter. Everybody up tight and close. Whoa, I don't know. And then Hooker with the quarterback sneak. He didn't need much, but he didn't get much, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, and you know they got to get to the 35 because it was a touchback on the kickoff.
It's fourth down.
It's like the goal line.
And they got it that time. Up and over by Jalen Wright.
Yeah, you look at the score 24-6, you go, we got to go for it.
Man, at your own 35-yard line.
I know.
Took some guts, but
you don't want to give the ball back to Georgia again the way your defense is playing.
And now I got a Tennessee guy down. And that's Jalen Hyatt. And he has an upset stomach, to say the least.
Hyatt was in on the wing position on this play on the quarterback sneak, and wonder if he got caught in some traffic. He's right here
behind Tillman. And
oh, the ball carrier lands right on his left side and buckles him with his left knee. The ball carrier, his own player, hits him in the knee. Watch him fly and hit him from the side. Oh,
little whiplash there.
Yep, and his left ankle gets trapped. Could be anything.
And that ankle wasn't so good in the first half either after running over the field judge. He's up, though. We'll be right back. Our aerial coverage of today's game brought to you by Goodyear as we zoom in between the hedges. Tennessee on offense. Jalen Hyatt shaking up on that previous play on the sideline right now, but looks like he'll be okay. Has not been a factor. Came in with over 900 yards receiving and 14 touchdowns. And he has three catches for not that much so far today. First down, though, for his teammates at their own 36. Georgia with a blitz. And running right by it is Jalen Wright after the 40. Give him four. It'll be second down and six.
So trying to figure out what is Georgia's defense doing that has taken away the big plays that Alabama couldn't stop or anybody else. Looks to me like they're just playing man-to-man. They're saying, we're going to cover them. We're not going to make mistakes trying to switch. I got my guy. Let's see if you can beat me.
Play action. Hooker double pumps, throws high but complete to Tillman. That's a first down. You know, one thing Kirby Smart told us yesterday, talking about this high-powered Tennessee offense and everything, he said, you know what? They got to look us in the eye.
That's for sure. Well, I'll tell you, I thought Tillman might have hurt that ankle again That's the one that he had surgery on with the tightrope. Remember, been back a week, kind of had a pitch count last week. Now they've been using him full speed. He got tackled and kind of trapped on that ankle. Could be just a scare.
Right.
We'll see.
First and 10. Georgia fans decide to make some noise after coming back from their halftime hot dogs. They caused some penalties in the first half. Hooker, first down to Hyatt, who's back out there right at the midfield stripe.
Patience. You know, it looks bad, 24-6. But remember, you know, 8 points here changes the look of the game.
Second down and 7. Ramel Keaton in the lineup to take Cedric Tillman's spot, at least on this snap.
He's the widest defender stacked, or offensive receiver stacked right there.
And now Hooker on a keeper. Damon Hooker got about 13 before he's run out of bounds at the 40 of Georgia. Christopher Smith was there to meet him, but that's only about the third design run by Hooker. They've all been effective at varying degrees anyway.
It's exactly what Tennessee needed, though. 8-play drive, keep the ball.
Hooker running out of time.
Oh,
and
man.
Took a big shot in the backfield. He's going down. And that was Jamon Dumas Johnson. Quite a collision.
Tried to get a fake, and Dumas Johnson said, I'm not getting faked on this one. I'm going to lay the leather on you. And he did.
Dumas Johnson, top tackler for Georgia, and a big one there. Forces a second and 15. Right.
That's pretty much been on schedule for Tennessee. On second down, they like to run the ball, keep their receivers close to the line of scrimmage so they can go fast on third down.
Now the guy that made that big hit is down for Georgia. Number 10, not on this play, but on the one that we just saw. We'll take a break and check on Jamon when we come back. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Sonic. Voya. Dr. Pepper. And by T-Mobile. And we'll get coming up later in the game. We'll have our play of the game presented by Jersey Mike Subs. Tennessee is only 1 out of 8 on third down conversion so far.
And
they've
for
got
the
third
year,
down and 13 right now.
And for the year, they're 50%.
Hasn't been a normal day for their offense.
Got to believe that offensive coordinator Alex Golish and Josh Heupel are figuring, how close do we got to get to go for it on fourth down?
11th play of the drive and the biggest one of the drive so far. Third down and 13. Blitz coming off the corner. Hooker's in trouble. He's going down. Dropped at midfield by Warren Brinson.
Aggressive defense, because right now the Georgia defensive backs feel that they can cover him. Actually, it was a zone blitz that time. Played zone in the middle of the field. They brought an extra player. Just happened too fast. There was a lot of field to throw to, but he got him too quickly.
And with that, they have to punt. Vlad McConkie waits on the kick from Paxton Brooks. As you look behind Brooks. Wow, they got close to him on that kick. End over end punt. McConkie's going to fair catch it around the 13. And so just over 5 minutes played in quarter number 3. Georgia and their defense still dominating. Yeah, ever since then, Bo Nix and the Ducks have been rolling since that massacre in the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta,
yeah,
beginning of the season.
Really helps Georgia, doesn't it? Every time that Oregon wins, I mean, you know, Georgia gets into the SEC championship. Remember, Last year they lost and still got in it. If they get there undefeated and Oregon keeps winning, they're pretty much going to be winning in it.
Still 25 minutes left in this one. And Georgia in command at the moment. Kenny McIntosh with Stetson Bennett in the backfield on the carry. And he drags folks with him for about 4 yards. Bring up second and six. Time to test your knowledge right now with today's Aflac trivia question. Which is the only team to miss the playoff after debuting at number one in the initial college football poll?
Tennessee fans right now are going, oh, no.
Yeah. We don't want that.
Yes.
Second down, six. Quick play fake and trying to get it to Bowers on a slant, incomplete. It'll be third down for Georgia.
Yeah, that's an RPO that time. Quarterback has the option of handing that ball off. Got one-on-one. Decent coverage. A little bit high, right?
Yep.
Too high, too fast. It's Marion McDonald. Good job, but a good throw would have had it. Remember we talked about that first blitz. Really, since then, there has not been the pressure on Stetson Bennett. Can Tennessee get some pressure on this quarterback?
Jackson and McConkey to the right side where Bowers is in the slot on third and six. Bennett fires complete to McConkey. He's been one of his main targets today. First down, Georgia.
Seems like they have really circled Slaughter. Zero came in a week ago against Kentucky, had a great game. He's got a kind of a hybrid again, one of those safety corners playing off. They got it slot slant right in front of him. You know, that's a tough match. My guy that's played safety most of the time came in against Kentucky, had a great football game. But today, remember that out and up was on him for the touchdown by McConkey. That time they come with the slant.
Part of McConkey's 71 yards through the air, including that touchdown that Gary was talking about. And there's the numbers on Stetson Bennett. Robert Beal, you saw for Georgia, going to the locker room. Here's the end around by Brock Bowers.
And that's the play that Bowers ran, the 70-yard plus touchdown. Gets it on a full head of steam, running at the outside. They've got three tight ends in the game that time. Oscar Delp, number four, zero Washington, and 19 Bowers. Three of them in that time.
Bowers has had three plays of over 75 yards. And the rain starts to fall in Athens. Just kind of popped up out of nowhere. First down run by McIntosh. Georgia getting a little head of steam on this drive, both through the air and on the ground.
So we
would love to use about six more minutes of clock here.
Yeah, this third down game has been big for Georgia. The contrast, Ness told you, 1 for 9 for Tennessee, 4 for 6 for Georgia.
And the rain is pretty heavy, as a matter of fact, right now. First and 10 from the 36. McIntosh.
Oh, nice tackle.
Nice move. Yeah, nice move and nice tackle. Slaughter brought him down.
Nico Slaughter comes up, makes the play.
Nico had an interception and basically forced a second one last week in that Kentucky game that one of his teammates took after a big hit that he made. But we're past the midway point of the third quarter in the rain of Georgia, and Georgia leading 24-6. Dejon Edwards now back in there. Stetson Bennett trying to keep his hands dry. Gives it off to Edwards. Going nowhere. Nice play by Juwan Mitchell.
Yep, tried to run the counter play that time. Pulling the backside guard and following the tight end on the play. Great penetration for that defensive line. They are a one-gap team defense. They don't play two-gap where they try to hold the guy in front of them. They pick a crease and they go upfield trying to get those tackles for loss. Third down again. They need it here, don't they?
Quarterbacks way in favor of Stetson Bennett. Third down and 9. McConkey in motion up top. Bowers is on that side with him. The throw's going to McConkey with Bowers blocking for him, and McConkey's got not only a first down, but a lot more. All the way to the 40-yard line.
How about this misdirection play to McConkey. What a beautifully designed play. You're pulling linemen this way, faking the back this way, to the right, and then you throw to the left. Beautifully designed play.
That's closing in on a 100-yard game now for McConkey, and a big 23-yard pickup on that one.
Tell you, Todd Monken is dialing it up today.
Isn't he?
He's just keeping this Tennessee defense off balance on every play.
Edwards, I don't know how he got eight out of that. Thought he was going to be stopped for a yard gain, and he just kept those legs moving.
106 yards career high versus Florida last week. Big push inside. Rutledge, McClendon, Van Pran. Van Pran, 63, the Georgia center, just in another long line of Georgia centers that just handle this offense. Physical, smart, calling out all the signals.
As you see him do there. And now Branson Robinson comes in, fresh body in the backfield with Bennett on second down and two. He'll get the carry. Not going to get the first down, though. Oh,
not enough push that time.
Byron Young in on the stop. But look at the clock.
Yeah. And I would think that for this play now, this short yardage situation, a little too far for a field goal. I would assume that Georgia would think, if we don't make it on one play, we'll go for it on two plays.
They're down and two. Edwards gets it this time. First down, Georgia, and he's still going again. Backpedaling for the second time on this drive.
Yeah, now barring a few incompletions, that's going to kill another 2 minutes off this clock. And now they are in field goal range. Running to the right again. I'll tell you, when you have Washington in there, I mean, it is really like having three tackles in the football game. The contrast between Washington and Bowers is amazing.
Yep.
What they do. They all both have their own strengths, the way they're used, the way they can line up anywhere in the formation.
At the 26. Edwards, second effort again, goes for about four.
When we asked Kirby Smart, I think it was Kirby, we talked to him, might have been Coach Monken, what does Edwards bring in? He goes toughness and vision when he runs the ball, right? That was his word he used. He seems to find those cracks as good as anybody we have. He uses his vision to find out what the next play is right now.
Now Georgia shortens up that line of scrimmage again with the tight ends in tight on each side. Second down and seven. And they're just going to block for number 30, who get a yard more as we check in with Jenny.
Yeah, it's been very busy with injuries down here on the Georgia sideline. We have Robert Beal. He is now in the locker room. It's a neck injury. He's being further evaluated. As far as Dumas Johnson goes, I'm told he's good to go back in the game, guys.
All right, Jenny, thanks. Stay dry. I know you're not. Third down coming up. Georgia has chewed up this clock in the third quarter.
Yeah, I thought that time that Stetson, if he did have a zone read keep on there, he could have kept that one. Wonder if they'll run site, some type of run for the quarterback on this play, because I thought it was there.
Third down and six. They need to get to the 16 for a first down. McIntosh only got about a yard.
Yep, same thing. They're going to, I would assume from here, they got to be thinking field goal, don't they?
Yeah, Podlesny. Well within his range. He's 14 out of 16 out of the year. Well, he's 15 out of 17 because he hit one earlier in the game. A little different when you're playing in that kind of conditions, but he's been pretty steady for them since his walk-on year in 2018. Made one, a chip shot from 19 earlier, and now Bennett will hold. This will be a 37-yard attempt for Jack Podlesny. Up and good. Tack three more on for the Dogs.
Still a three-possession lead, but now it's three touchdowns instead of two and a field goal.
Most of the third quarter belonged to Georgia, and they've tacked three more on and lead 27-6. CBS tomorrow. Critics agree the new hit show East New York is great network TV, starring Amanda Warren, Jimmy Smits, and Richard Kind. Catch a new East New York tomorrow after FBI on CBS. Stay dry, Olga. Of course, he has his own shield there, so he can't get wet. A little bit earlier, we asked you the Aflac trivia question, and it was
Aflac.
Which is the only team to miss the playoff after debuting at number one in the initial college football poll? Remember Mississippi State when they had that great run there in 2014?
Those games, yep, Dak Prescott.
Yep. That's what it looked like October 28th of 2014, and lo and behold, the number 16 team in that poll won the national title. As Gary said, Tennessee fans don't want to hear that. They come into this one number one, but they're getting outplayed by number three pretty badly. Hooker in trouble again. Double clutches, throws, and it is caught by Brew McCoy.
One of the coaching points that Georgia's defense was making is that Hendon Hooker does not drop back deep. He stays at about 6.5 yards, and they needed to pressure up the middle.
And finally, they get a little crossing route on a slant to Jalen Hyatt, who has not been a factor.
They were contrasting Bryce Young, who takes a shotgun and goes back about 9 to 10 yards, whereas Hendon Hooker catches it and just turns right there at 6. Means the edge rushers have a tough time getting there.
Try a draw play, and the ball is out, and Georgia's got it. Tyrion Ingram Dawkins.
And I think it was Jalen Carter that caused the fumble.
Jalen Wright's the one that dropped it in the rain. And that's not going to help Tennessee's cause.
This would be the second cause fumble if it's done by 88. Blows it up, reaches from behind, and makes the play. That's two forced fumbles.
Didn't we say he'd be a factor?
He is.
He is. And now the crowd is really wound up.
Ness, going into this game, I thought good defense for Georgia against Tennessee would, if they had 8 or 10 possessions, if they could hold them with no points half the time. Okay, so that's 8 possessions by Tennessee, just 2
field goals. Yeah.
I always thought if they could go with half, it would be good defense. They're playing, and they're in charge of this football game. This Georgia defense is. And remember, this defense lost 5 number one draft picks and N'Kobe Dean.
Remember Georgia last time they had a sudden change at a one play touchdown from that spot, and now the ball is out for Georgia, and Tennessee's got it back.
Yes, they do.
So it's getting a little slippery down there, and both tailbacks on back to back plays cough it up. It's funny, number 20 fumbled for Tennessee, and number 20
recovered
for Tennessee.
Robinson in the game, helmet right on the football that time. That makes the play, and it was Flowers right on the football. That might have come out even if it was a dry football.
So back-to-back turnovers here in the last half minute of quarter number three.
Think about this, the long pass reception of the game by Tennessee is 17 yards.
Wow, I haven't heard it this loud in this place in a long time. Final 19 seconds of the half. Hooker throws out, Cedric Tillman with a flag down, and Tillman goes down after a pickup of 9. And we'll wait and see on the penalty. That'll stop things here, and the third quarter won't end. At least not yet.
Illegal formation, offense. More than 4 players in the backfield. Number 11 was not on the line of scrimmage. 5-yard penalty, team first down.
I think that's the fifth pre-snap penalty for Tennessee in this game. And as Ness said, it's the loudest it's been.
It's almost like the rain has revived the crowd. And here they come again. Probably the final play of the quarter. First and 15 for the Volunteers, and now we've got a timeout.
How about that misalignment that time by the Georgia secondary, and Kirby goes, no, 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 we are not making a big mistake with 4 seconds to go in the third quarter.
I'll use a timeout and the heck with it. So yep. 4 seconds remaining in the quarter. And we'll take a quick timeout with them, see what Hendon Hooker and Josh Heupel and company have got in store for us. From our AT&T 5G pylon cam, you can see it's getting a little soggy here in Athens. Final play of the third quarter, barring a penalty. Hendon Hooker waits, pumps, in trouble. Trying to run out of that trouble, and he got to the 40, but not to the first down marker. Tyke Smith put a hit on him to end the quarter. Wanted to go down the middle and then had to run for his life. The Georgia defense stretches it out, makes the hit at the 40. And we played three in Athens. The red lights will come up. Will the orange lights be put out by the Dogs in the fourth quarter? We'll find out. The red ring signals the end of three and the beginning of the fourth quarter here at Sanford Stadium, the Home Depot SEC on CBS. A quarter to go, all Georgia right now. Tennessee trying to fight their way back in it. Second down and 4 to open the quarter at their own 40-yard line.
Light box, very light box, just 5 people in the box for Tennessee.
With that, they'll keep it on the ground to Jalen Wright, and he's got a first down and almost a face mask at the end of that play.
Absolutely. That's what they do. They count on every play. That's why it looks as that Tennessee runs so many play action passes, because the run is always available.
Georgia brings an extra rusher. Hooker finally going deep. Man there. McCoy, and he overshot him.
And that was an amazing throw, considering Hooker got hit just as he let that ball go.
Drew McCoy had a step back there.
I think it was Stackhouse number 78 that got in there, but McCoy runs right by. I think it's Smith 23 and just overthrow. Watch his throw with a guy right in your chops.
That close, but incomplete. Second and 10. Tennessee looking for that big chunk play. They've been unable to get today, and it's not going to come there either. Tillman leveled immediately by Keely Ringo. Jenny.
Yeah, I asked one of the equipment managers if there's anything that they do to try to keep the balls dry. They actually dump them in a bag of sand. They said it's a shake and bake method, and then they use a towel to dry that ball off from the sand, and they hope that it stays a little bit drier, but you see it's been causing issues out there, guys.
No doubt. Probably two down territory right here for Hooker. On third and 3, the throw's complete. It's a first down anyway to Cedric Tillman. Again, so Tillman, who was limping a little bit after that one catch on the far side, back in there here in the fourth quarter.
Think back to how Kirby started this game talking to Jenny, where he said our perimeter has to be great. They have been great.
Yeah, they
it's
have.
Just amazing how few big plays they're giving up. They're forcing Tennessee to rhythmically move the ball down the field. Nothing behind. They had a couple shots, but it has to be perfect downfield.
Even if they score here, if Georgia puts a drive together like their last one that took 9 minutes, yeah, the game's going to be over.
Yep. But you can only go one at a time.
Yep.
You got to take what they're giving you, and they're forcing you to go the long route.
They'll run it with Wright to the 30, and it'll be third down and 7. Now it's only going to be third down and 4, beg your pardon. Georgia again with that shift on their front wall. Hooker, the quick look to the right. The high throw is incomplete. Intended. Oh, flag's coming in. Keely Ringo lost his helmet and he lost his receiver. And he picked up the penalty.
Well, Keely Ringo knows that Cedric Tillman is physical. So he's been challenged to be physical himself. And he has been. Gets his hand on him. Gets there just before the ball does.
Holding.
Pretty good
defense,
coverage, though.
Not too bad.
10-yard penalty from the previous
but
spot.
Enough to give Tennessee a first down.
I'll say this, that if he got there beforehand, there was no way that they're not going to call that. But if you're Georgia, you're taking that. I mean, you got a guy fighting out there. He goes, oh, really? Have you tried to cover number four before?
Of course, he had a big interception in the end zone in the first half. Trying to make a play there. And a penalty gives Tennessee the first down. They're right at the edge.
Remember, his helmet came out, so they got a backup
right.
Everett in there covering Tillman on this play.
They're at the edge of the red zone, and they need a touchdown. Three quarters without one. Highest scoring team in the country. About a 3-yard pickup for Jalen Wright. Zion Logue made the hit. And they got to go fast. That's their MO anyway, but time is of the essence. Hooker waiting too long again. Down he goes again. Tresman Marshall with a sack this time.
What a play. Watch him on the left side. He gets blocked. Gets taken to the ground. Gets up with a roll and gets the sack. What a play.
Somersault sack.
Yep.
And now it's back to third and long again.
Just again, over and over. Just think about what these Georgia defensive backs are doing with these skilled big play receivers. A lot of people have been saying these receivers are like the LSU receivers. And here we go again. Five more yards. That was the talk all week, that this set of receivers for Tennessee was very similar to that 2019 group.
5-yard penalty.
Number six, you think, false start? I think it's I'd say at least six.
The numbers on the two quarterbacks. Stetson Bennett's accounted for three scores, two in the air, one with his legs. This crowd is worth about 10 points, if you ask me. And the Georgia defenders are asking for more of it. Hooker is going down again.
Same blitz that got him before. Three-man line. Bring the rush off the slot. They catch the blocks, and the two inside linebackers bail to zone. Watch the two inside linebackers bail out, come off the edge, get the sack.
Javon Buller just too fast off that corner for anybody to even get a hand on him almost.
Yep. Same look, same result.
And now Tennessee's got to go for it on fourth down in about 2 miles. They have no choice. Fourth and 23.
I think you either go throw it up for grabs. You either go to McCoy or Tillman up in the air. Let them jump up and try to make a play. Another one.
Another false start.
Another false start. They could feel the blitz coming. And I think it was Wright again moved before the snap.
False start. Offense number 88. 5-yard penalty.
A frustrated Josh Heupel. 18th pre-snap penalty of the day.
And we're getting word that's their seventh illegal procedure penalty. How about that?
You see 88 with the movement.
Very similar to what Alabama had to endure when they played at Tennessee, remember?
Yep. Now it's fourth down. And a prayer. Hooker, will he even have time to get rid of this one? He will not. The Georgia defense just eating up things.
Uh-oh, right at the end. They're going to get a first down here. Face mask or late hit.
I thought it might have been a hold. We'll find out. It's a big penalty. If it's on Georgia.
No, no. Kirby says. Was it on number 11, Walker?
Personal foul, face mask.
You're right, Gary.
Defense number 13.
13. Boy, I mean, no hope for a first down. And you feel it inside. This time it was Williams. End of the play. Yeah, he's got him. He's got him by the face mask.
Definitely don't need to do that.
And I actually think it was Walker that had the, he got the wrong number. It was Walker that had the face mask.
So a huge penalty against Georgia. They haven't had any hardly all day long.
Almost believe the game was practically over with that stop.
So now new life for the Volunteers. Still a long way for them to go, but still 10 minutes left. Hooker is going to run. Gets inside the 20, down around the 18. Zion Logue again in the middle of that Georgia defensive front made the tackle. And we are under 10 minutes remaining. Second down and 5. Blitz coming. Hooker with the throw off McCoy's hands and completes.
Nice switch coverage that time by this Georgia secondary. Lassiter, it's a switch release by the stack receivers, and Georgia watch the receiver switch and the DBs follow it, run right through it. No pick at all, and Lassiter makes the hit.
Slipperiness of the ball might have had something to do with that, but McCoy could have caught it. But he took the hit from Lassiter as soon as the ball arrived. Third down at 6. Hendon Hooker's thrown a touchdown pass in 20 straight games. He still doesn't have one today, but they need one. Blitz. Hooker going down again.
She's same blitz.
Javon Bullard again.
Same guy. Hey, if it's working, why not keep doing it, right? Coming off the left edge, the blind spot for the quarterback. He's timing it up because of the clap, the loud noise. He knows they cannot fake the snap count. He times it up. And what's he got, 3 of these? At least.
Fourth down. Hooker, that one sailed on him due to the weather, I think, and incomplete. And Georgia takes over on downs.
What a defensive performance by this secondary. They're getting good pressure inside by the front four, but the blitz package that Will Muschamp and Glenn Schumann, the two coordinators, the two lieutenants for Kirby Smart's defense, has kept them off balance all day.
Back in Athens, as we take a look at our game recap, Stetson Bennett's been excellent today. Hendon Hooker's had the day he'd like to forget so far. Georgia defense has held Tennessee to only 208 yards total. This crowd has been a huge factor. We welcome you back, Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson. Jenny's trying not to drown down on the field. You know, we did a bunch of games last year for Georgia. 5 number one picks off that defense. These guys maybe not as big of names. This is as good as I've seen them play defense in a long time.
There's no doubt about it. They seem to have the game plan that what Tennessee wants to do. Kirby challenges corner, said, listen, we're not going to give them gimmies. We're going to cover them, and if you don't cover them, we're going to lose.
Right.
Okay, we're not making mistakes, switching, doing all the things that other people tried to do. You got the guy in front of you. Let's see if you can cover him.
He said, we're not going to give him any layups. They haven't even given him any three-point shots today, much less layups.
And I think that as much, if this thing holds on the way it is, the way Georgia has dominated this game, and considering their schedule in front of them, I mean, they're going to walk into the SEC championship game and win or lose, they're in the playoffs.
That's how much this last 9 minutes means. Dejon Edwards in the backfield with Bennett. If they can go on a drive like the last one they had, they could end this thing. That one's not going to start it. Omari Thomas with a nice tackle. We check in with Jenny.
Hey guys, we know that Nolan Smith is out for the season with a torn pec, but Kirby Smart asked him to stay involved, lift spirits, push teammates. That's exactly what he is doing out here. Coach said that Smith creates an attitude of toughness that embodies their defense. It's been fun to watch. He's running around screaming, all-time defense. And he's got a really nice Stetson Bennett shirt on,
He sure does. He's one of the first guys that said he's Stetson Bennett's our guy. He's not just the offense's guy. He's our guy.
Yep. It happened, I think, in this game last year that Stetson won his team over.
Second down and 12. Trying to keep it on the ground. They utilize some clock here. Flags fly in. Probably a holding call.
You know, and as Jenny just pointed out, not having Nolan Smith, I mean, we've got, you know, five number one draft picks on the defense. Then N'Kobe Dean, who was almost
offense,
MVP on defense for them
penalty.
A year ago.
Butker's winner.
Yep. And then now they lose Nolan Smith this year. I mean, that's quite a rebuild. And why those recruiting classes stacked one after another has got this Georgia football team in a position to win this big game.
And a team that came in last in the conference with only 10 sacks. And somebody said, you guys only had 10 sacks, and they've been screaming about that, the Georgia fans, that they don't get pressure. Today, they've gotten pressure. And Hendon Hooker is the guy that's felt it all day long. Georgia in the huddle, using some clock here. Should work down under 8 minutes on the next snap.
Right now, if you're Stetson Bennett, every time you're in the huddle, you tell the carrier, ball security, ball security.
In this case, Dejon Edwards secures the ball, but he doesn't gain anything, and it's third down and 22. Jeremy Banks in on the stop. Some news and notes.
Man,
your old teammate passed away.
Absolutely. We were freshmen together at Purdue in 1972.
Played in a lot of charity golf tournaments with Dave. What a fun guy to be around. And the Aggies continue their slide. Florida beat them today. Longest losing streak in since 1980. Wow, I didn't realize it was that much. So College Station is not happy right now. Oh. Athens, Georgia is, and they'll be even happier 7 minutes from now, knowing that their team will be back on top of the college football rankings. And as Gary said, inside track to everything they've been looking for in defending their crown. Edwards trying to weave it outside. Nice job. Banks again makes the stop around the 15. And Georgia will use as much clock as they can and then kick this thing away.
You know, a year ago, we thought about that T-shirt that Nolan Smith was wearing in Stetson's game, especially in the first half. You know, a year ago, they played to their defense. They just did. They didn't let Stetson Bennett lose any games. They just knew they were. But this year, Stetson's carrying this team. And he's throwing a lot of balls. He's got, again, what has he got in this game? 30 balls again he's thrown in this football game? They have been an offensive juggernaut compared to a defensive team a year ago. He has to get credit for that.
Absolutely. Average 200 on the ground and 328 through the air. This punt fielded around the 40. That's where the Volunteers will have it back, but they don't have a lot of time to work with. 6:16 is all we've got left. The Home Depot SEC on CBS. Sponsored by Invesco QQQ. Jersey Mike Subs. Wheels up. And by Smile Direct Club. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Jenny Dell in a soggy Athens, Georgia, where there's only 6:16 remaining. And it's time for our GMC Game Changers. Game-changing defense of Georgia.
Yeah, from all different angles, their All-American Jalen Carter back in the game, forcing two turnovers in the football game, basically two turnovers. Second one there, almost a touchdown on the other one. Then the blitz package coming from all different angles has been a problem for this Tennessee team. A little bit late reacting to that blitz off the edge. And the defense and the coverage, we talked about it all game. They forced Tennessee to not do what they want to do. And now with 6 minutes to go, you just really can't take what the defense gives you. You got to throw the ball.
Got to force it.
You got to force it.
Six sacks today. They only had 10 coming in through 8 weeks. Center judge was not out of the way. I don't know if they blew the ball dead. I don't think it's going to be a penalty. And Hendon Hooker's telling our referee, Jason Autry, hey, let us go. We don't have much time left. Don't hold us up. So there wasn't a flag. Center Judge backpedals out of the way, and now Tennessee's offense from the 39. Right, got it to the 45.
Same read. That time the Georgia defense put three defensive linemen, two linebackers. They gave the run look to Tennessee, and Tennessee took it.
Jalen Wright came up limping a little bit after that run as well. Hooker, quick throw behind his receiver, but he still pulled it in. Brew McCoy. And McCoy and his blockers get it into Georgia territory down around the 46.
Ness, you know, another thing that watching this game has popped in mind a little bit. Throughout this whole game, linebackers, defensive backs, defensive linemen, I haven't seen a missed tackle by Georgia all game.
Yeah, they really have done a nice job in the open field. Hooker's got plenty of time this time and throws a strike over to McCoy again. So we got a flag down.
Yeah, I think there's going to be holding the slot receiver that time on the Georgia defense.
Holding defense number 32.
Yep.
The penalty is declined. Results of the play is a first down.
Chaz Chambliss.
He was lined up over the slot, and he goes, I got a receiver, and I'm a defensive end. I'm grabbing him.
Yep.
Oh, look at Kirby goes.
He's getting coached up over
yep.
there, too.
They're all used to that. If you've ever gone to a Georgia practice, you see a lot of that.
You can't have thin skin.
Nope.
First down, Tennessee, but we're down to 5.5 minutes to go. And they're still in the huddle. Sugar huddle, albeit. But we'll barely get a play off here. Not quite sure what the holdup was. They just do get it off. Hooker can't find a receiver. He's going to try to run for it. Some nice moves, but only about a 2-yard gain.
Don't know why he didn't let that ball go deep that time. He had a deep ball with no coverage to the left side of the sideline. You know, you're down 3 touchdowns. Just let it go.
That was McCoy.
Yep.
Again, a little indecisive in trying to go to McCoy in a comeback route, and that one's broken up by Lassiter.
Backs. Look it to the right side this time. Slot receiver. He's got a possibility going deep. Throw the ball deep. Nobody back there. Seems like he's picking the wrong side for whatever reason. He's not getting the ball on the big plays. They're not all perfectly covered. And he had a couple big chances right there.
He's chosen wisely through the first 8 weeks of the season. Today is just not there. Cooper Mays was the guy that was shaken up. Got poked in the eye, it appears. And he's still trying to clear that off. Invesco brings you today's scholar athletes to Trub Bumpus and Brock Bowers. Invesco proud to support student athletes on and off the field with a donation of $1,000 to both Tennessee and Georgia's general scholarship funds. Third down and 9, Tennessee still without a touchdown and only 4:46 remaining in the ballgame. Hooker's in trouble. Got away from it. Now he can't throw, and he walks out of bounds with a 1-yard gain.
Amazing. Tennessee knew from the alignment that it was man-to-man coverage. All year, those receivers have just been putting fright in front of any defensive back as they faced it. And in this game, nothing. I mean, he knew pre-snap that it was man all over the field.
This might be the last time they touch the ball if they don't get a first down.
Here it comes again, man coverage.
Throws down the middle and got it, a strike down near the 5-yard line to Hyatt. And now they'll hustle down there to first and goal.
Yeah, Malachi Starks that time, the safety's on Hyatt. Runs the inside post off the read, ball's delivered. Finally, they got the play they wanted. Seems a little late though.
And they got a touchdown as well on the next play, Jalen Wright. So first it was Jalen Hyatt, then Jalen Wright, and Tennessee finally has a touchdown.
Fit very nicely by that offensive line that time. Jalen Wright goes in, you got to take the extra point to make it 13, a 14-point game, and you think onside kick, try to get the ball back.
Chase McGrath in for the point after.
Boy, one of those earlier, huh? In the third quarter or something?
Yeah.
And you get a whole different feel here.
Extra point is good. So Jalen Hyatt, the 28-yard reception, got it down to the 5. And then Jalen Wright from 5 yards out caps a 61-yard drive in 2 minutes to close the gap. CBS.
Well, remember last time a conservative Georgia offense was a 3-and-out. So do you kick it deep and try to use your timeouts to get it back, or do you go onside kick right here? You know what I already said I'd do. I'd go onside kick.
They have not had an onside kick this year. They haven't needed one. They need one now, and here it comes. Going the other way, and Georgia's Darnell Washington's got it right at the 10-and-a-half-yard mark.
Yeah, it was a good stop by them, and had a nice bounce to it. Well played, fake to the right side, and then they kick it back, and Big Zero just swallows it.
That's a good word. Ball kind of disappears in his stomach, doesn't it? So that's his best catch of the day, though he did have a few.
So the last 3-and-out was almost 3 minutes that Georgia took off the clock, but this time Tennessee will use their timeouts. Georgia's going to need one first down to keep this Tennessee team off the field.
So they came in number 1 in the college football rankings, and they look to be headed back to Knoxville without that number 1, and the guys in red and black will have it, we assume, next week.
You know what else is different right now? It appears that the rain has stopped. You wonder if they would be a little more aggressive without the rain right now. Georgia, I mean.
First down at the 46. Kendall Milton in the backfield will get the carry.
Nothing.
Head on by Aaron Beasley as we check in with Jenny.
Yeah, guys, I think we learned something about Stetson Bennett yesterday, that he's a reader. He likes some Winston Churchill quotes, and he likes to apply them to football. One in particular, he couldn't understand and couldn't remember the exact quote, but he said, you know, it takes you a moment to step back and simplify the game. You got to look at the defense, and there's clarity in your mind, not as complicated as you might convince yourself when it comes to football. So he's a smart man there, guys.
He's been pretty clear-headed today, I think. Kirby Smart, that last time out, I said to Gary, what's Kirby going crazy about?
Block.
Block somebody.
Yes. He's right in that offensive line's pace. He does not want his defense to go back on the field.
Well, let's see if they block somebody. Got second down and 8. Toss, nope. Sweep. Didn't nope. Block the right
not
guy there.
Not at all.
Beasley again.
Could not get the hook block that time. Didn't want to go up the middle. Just attacking and just beat the pulling guard to the spot. Nice job by Beasley. Back-to-back plays.
And back-to-back timeouts for Tennessee. Just under 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. 30-second timeout. We'll be right back. Still to come, the college football postgame show presented by Rocket Mortgage. Stay tuned. Adam, Rick, and BJ weigh the ramifications of this one and bring you the best highlights from around the country. That's all coming up. Postgame show presented by Rocket Mortgage, which is just over 4 minutes away. Kirby Smart wanted this crowd to come early and be loud. They did both, and they were helpful with 4 minutes remaining, holding a 2-touchdown lead here.
Yeah, do you let Stetson Bennett throw the football here? If it is, it'll be a little bootleg, a safe throw.
Bowers, his tight end, along with Darnell Washington, both lined up on the right side of the formation. And he will throw. And he's going to go for all of it. Man out there. Broken up. It was Arian Smith. And a nice job defensively by Wesley Walker.
Yeah, I thought the ball was catchable. That's what Stetson Bennett said. Did it go right through his arms? Into the play? It did.
Went
right through his arms. It was not even, I mean, it was good coverage, but it was never touched. Stetson goes, and what is it? Either a short pass, or if it's picked off, it's going to happen way down by the goal line. Good call by Coach Munkin on that one. But that ball could have been caught. What happened? He said.
Yeah, meanwhile, this guy who had one of the plays of the game, Brett Thorson, set to punt. He'd love to knock another one out inside the one-yard line like he did on that 75-yarder. This one's going to go too far. Hits at the one and into the end zone. So touchback. He wanted one more of those.
Game's not over. I'll tell you that right now. We've seen Hail Marys winning this thing.
You're not kidding. Remaining schedule, Missouri, South Carolina, and Vandy. They'll be favored in all of those games, regardless of being home or on the road.
And every point, if they get another touchdown, this loss will look better as time goes by.
So let's see what they've got. They've only got one timeout remaining. And this crowd has not left the stadium despite the rain. And they know that they have caused havoc with this offense. They're going to give it one more shot here at making things hard on the offense of the Volunteers. Hooker, pocket collapsing again, but he's going to run out of there. And close to a first down, dives forward.
But short, which means the clock will not stop.
He got a whole bunch of Dooley Field in his face mask. Second down, a short two. Jalen Wright's got the first down. That'll stop things momentarily while they move the sticks. Now you would assume that Hooker's got to go back to the air. They've only got one timeout left.
Three-man rush.
Has time, throws the out on the far side. It's complete, and he's inbounds. That's Brew McCoy. And now we're going to be under 3 minutes probably on the next snap by the time everybody gets lined up. Here comes the Georgia blitz. Hooker standing tall, going deep. Far sideline, just over the outstretched arms.
Close.
Now Princeton Fant, the tight end.
So judging one of those speed receivers and a tight end is a bit different. Lay the ball out a yard too long.
Yep. That looked like the one Ramel Keaton caught on the other side of the field. That game we did earlier, but he's faster than that guy, but he gave everything he had to lay out for it. Still only two third down conversions out of 13 today. This one's manageable at third down and three. Hooker goes across the middle, broken up, incomplete, intended for McCoy. And it was Starks, Malachi Starks, who made the play.
Got there just as the ball did. Great close. The true freshman gets there right as the ball gets there. Fourth down.
Fourth down and three. And now if it's not there right now for Hendon Hooker, he's got to run for it. Anything he can do to keep possession of the football.
And Georgia has been blitzing in this situation. Will they do it again?
Jalen Hyatt in motion. And now they've shown their play because Jalen Wright went in motion and now stopped in the slot on the right. So Georgia knows where he is. Hooker thought about running. Now it's too late to run. Down he goes. Ryan Davis with another Georgia sack.
Ryan Davis started in the middle. There was an audible called by Georgia. He shifts at the last second to the left side of the Tennessee line. Look at him on the right side of the screen, number zero. Times it up, beats the block by the running back, and gets the play. Aggressive defense by Georgia all game. They never backed off, did they?
Nope. And they have swallowed up number five more times than he wants to remember today. And he was very slow getting up after the last one.
Yeah, he was thrown into the ground, and did he land on his left arm? He looks okay.
Tough day for Hendon Hooker, who's had just a brilliant, brilliant season up until today. The Georgia defense proving that they are what everybody thought they were.
Yeah, and you know, everybody says, well, why doesn't everybody just match up and cover these Tennessee receivers? Well, that's what recruiting all those top recruiting classes in a row. They've got the guys that can match up the athletes, and they did it. They just did it all game.
So Georgia takes over on downs, keeps it on the ground. Tennessee's only got one more way to stop it. Kendall Milton on the carry. And so far, they have not taken that timeout. Long day for the Volunteer fans. So excited about being number one in the country.
Yep. Well, just remember, when as Kirby built his program here at Georgia, it wasn't just a straight climb right to the top. When it came up, then took a little dip. There was a losses, you know, tough losses, and then eventually he got there. It's not very many people do it in the second year and take a national championship. What do we have? Four of them up that happened.
Yep. And some tough coaching, tough love there on Stetson Bennett, but the rest of his day has been pretty impressive. This was a huge play, getting away from a would-be sack, heading to the corner, diving to the pylon for the touchdown.
To me, that changed everything for the Tennessee blitz. They stopped blitzing up the middle. They started trying to keep him in the pocket and allowed throws like this, his best throw of the day, throwing right over the top of the defender, Jalen McCullough that time.
There's his numbers, 17 to 25, 257 and 2, and then that rushing touchdown we just showed you. Well, he's going to be 23 and 3 as a starter. That ain't bad. So each team just one timeout remaining and 1:54 to go.
I don't think Tennessee controls their end destiny if they lose this football game, but I do think they're still alive for the playoffs.
They go with the end around. Dejon Edwards knows he's supposed to stay in bounds. Yes, and does.
See him put on the brakes?
I'm not going to that sideline.
Yes. He had it going, and he goes, I might be able to get around that guy. I'm not. I saw Kirby yelling at Stetson Bennett.
And I don't want any of that. So now Georgia huddles, and we use all the way down almost to a minute before they have to snap it.
You get it under five, you've done your job as a quarterback. Under five.
It's there now. Now the quick clap all the way down to one. And the toss to Edwards. Edwards broke one tackle, weaving his way. That'll do it. First down, Georgia.
Forced a couple missed tackles. Ball security. Gets the first down and best play in football. Take a knee. Went wide again. They're thinking, let's at least bleed the clock. But Edwards, again, keeps his balance, keeps his eyes up. The great vision the coaches talked about. And that's it. Victory.
And now the victory formation for Bennett. One more snap. And Georgia goes to 9-0. 6-0 in the conference. And the only storming of the field here is the Georgia players to go surround their quarterback and shake hands with the opposition. And I don't think there'll be a doubt, although I'm not on the committee, that Georgia will be number one in next Tuesday's college football rankings. Jennings with the winning coach. Jennings.
Coach, you had the number one team in the country come in here. How were you able to just send them packing their bags the way that you just did?
A bunch of kids that love this place. We took zero out of the portal. They all love it here. They compete their ass off, and these fans are elite. I'm so proud for this university and these kids. They practice their butt off for 2 weeks.
Stetson had an incredible game. Your defense holding that number one offense to terms. You're out. Nolan Smith is gone. Beal gets hurt. What can you say about the way that this team performed?
They played together. They stuck to the plan. And when you stick to the plan, you got a hell of a chance. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. That was our theme. We told them we wanted to play them right here in our box.
You hunted them, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you. Good dogs.
Well, you think Kirby Smart's a happy coach today after picking off the number one team in the country? He pulled Jenny into that interview.
Yeah, that's a winner's handshake right there, isn't it?
No doubt. Down to Jenny with Stetson Bennett.
You had the number one team in the country come in here. Do you feel like you guys are playing with a little bit of a chip on your shoulder?
Yeah, I do. You know, we felt like we were the reigning ones. You got to come and see us on our field. And I think we played like it. We attacked this week. It was pretty sweet.
Congratulations.
The reigning champs, you got to come and play us. As Kirby said to us, they have to look us in the eye. Well, Georgia didn't blink, and Tennessee did. So here's how it looks in the SEC East. The indoor track now is for Georgia to make it to Atlanta at Mercedes-Benz Stadium from the East. They'll be favored in the rest of their games. Tennessee falls to 8-1 and 4-1 in the conference. Now it's time for the play of the game, presented by Jersey Mike Subs. There were a lot of special ones, especially off the arm of that quarterback, but maybe none bigger than this one to Rosemee Jack Saint on a high pass that he could only get. Here's how Scott Howard called it for the Georgia Radio Network.
Claps his hands. Bennett with the ball. Looks to the left. Throws it back line of the end zone. Reaching catch. He got the feet in. Touchdown. Marcus Rosemee. Jack Saint with a brilliant leaping catch right under the goalpost.
Jack Saint with a catch. The rest of the crowd has been jacked all day. They're a little wet, but they're happy. That's going to do it for us. For Gary Danielson, Jenny Dale, Gene Steratore, our entire CBS crew, Brad Nessler saying so long from Athens. Final score, Georgia 27, Tennessee 13. We'll get you back to Adam Zucker and company for the College Football Postgame Show presented by Rocket Mortgage after these messages. See you in Oxford next Saturday.